Beach Boys' Mike Love says he got a bad rap on his reputation. I'm John Beaudin from Rock History Music. When it comes to Mike Love, people do not tread lightly. There are websites set up to throw him shade. There are chat and Facebook groups that try to take him down. I'm sure some of the things that are being said about him are true. Some are probably exaggerations, and others, who knows? Most of the turmoil started in 1966 in the Beach Boys' groundbreaking album, Pet Sounds. A lot of reports said that he hated that project, but Love told Mojo magazine, at the time they were in the midst of Vietnam and student unrest and the integration and all that. When I delivered Pet Sounds with Brian to Capitol Records, played it for marketing, and marketing had no idea what to do with it. Carl Engelman, the A&R guy, said, "Mike and Brian, this is great, but couldn't you do something more like California Girls or I Get Around?" They wanted the same formula. And later on, years later, somebody comes along and says, "Mike Love says don't blank with the formula." I never said that. And the negative stuff that's attributed to me about Pet Sounds, are you crazy? Whoever thinks that, you're dumb. That's insane. Listen to the tracks, the orchestration, and the chord progressions, and everything else, and the vocals that we labored on for hours and hours and hours, doing 25, 30 takes of the A section of Wouldn't It Be Nice. That's when I started calling Brian dog ears. He was listening for something, reach for something that was otherworldly. He was hearing something out of reach of most of us mortals. At one time, he was unparalleled, unprecedented, and an incredibly brilliant guy. Love adds, then came LSD and the album Smile. And all those hangers-on thought they were so hip and so cool, bringing along the non-prescribed things. And it destroyed him. If I had been a psychologist and psychiatrist, I might have been able to deal with it. I might have been able to help Brian, Dennis, and Carl better. But no, I was the son of a sheet metal worker and a mother who loved music. I was not prepared to deal with the impact of friends doing LSD, cocaine, and heroin. We were reaching a point where we weren't honoring commitments, and I had just had it. We had the golden opportunity to be the world's greatest group, and we were destroying it due to all these destructive things. Love then goes on to say that he can trace it all back to Murray and the upbringing of the Wilson boys, where they had to feel like crap, which led to self-destructive behavior. Mike Love still tours under the moniker The Beach Boys, but what do you think? I don't think people will necessarily quickly change their minds when it comes to Mike Love. I've never talked to the guy, never tried to interview him, but you'd have to be living under a rock not to have heard all those stories. And some of them are really quite harsh. Make sure to comment on our video, subscribe to our channel, and share our videos. I'm John Beaudin from Rock History Music.